Hey, what's up, guys? We are here for our 10th mission in Halo Combat Evolved, which is the final mission. And here's the thing, slight problem. No Dan. Don't know why, but Dan is not here, so I have nobody to play with right now. And this mission's gonna suck on Heroic by myself. It'll take forever if I have to do it by myself, which, I mean, I can. I've done every Halo game by myself. But it takes a long time without checkpoints and stuff. So right now I'm just messing around trying to remember how to do this glitch where you can get the enemies to despawn and that kind of stuff. And I keep falling and it doesn't work. I mean, it works, but I'm not doing it right. So yeah, so I don't know what to do. I could go through on normal, or I could play on heroic by myself, and it would just take longer. I don't know. What do you guys think? What should we do? Well, let's just go ahead and start it. We are playing, and we'll just do it from the start like we always do. I think I'll probably just put it on normal and we'll run it that way. That'll work, right? That'll probably work. So what we've been doing is playing every mission on heroic because that's how they really intended the game to be played. I'm gonna do it on normal though, since I'm by myself. I don't want this video to be like 10 hours long, and I haven't played this mission in ages. Lots of ages. So we're gonna just play on normal. Grunt birthday party's on because why not? This is the final mission. So what's happening right now, story-wise, is we're going back to our broken-down giant ship, which is like really, really long. It's like 1.3 kilometers or something like that. It's a big ship. It doesn't look that big in the picture, but it is. And what we're gonna do is blow it up because we need to blow up the Halo ring. We need to stop it from firing or everybody dies. And so the only way to really do that is to just blow up the ship because the ship will create a big enough explosion that it'll stop the Halo ring from firing. So that's our plan. So we're getting there via the Banshee, which we stole at the end of last mission after we tried to save Captain Keys, but were unsuccessful. We're gonna see how much of this mission I remember, because it's been a very long time since I've played this. To initiate an overload of the ship's fusion engines. The explosion should damage enough systems below it to destroy the ring. Oh, that was a great grenade throw. These little flood guys are actually not much of a threat at all, but the sentinels are surprisingly effective. What you want to use is your plasma weapons to take them out, because they die almost instantly with the plasma weapons. With the ballistics weapons, the UNSC weapons, not so effective, believe it or not. Don't fall the trap of fighting these guys because they come around the corner and they will beat you up quickly. They have lots of guns. Tricked him. The first one always brings a shotgun, so if you just wait back and kill him, he'll basically throw it to you. So it's kind of helpful. Because lots of dudes are going to come in around this corner, raw cheer. Oh, what? 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 My grenade didn't kill him. Can I make a collection or display video? Yes, I plan to. Once I have it all up on display. I currently have everything in storage. Hey, Dan's here. We can play with Dan. Alright. That'll be better. Alright, I got the new interface on the Xbox. It's weird. Haven't had that happen. I mean, I had it happen before, but not so delayed. Dan! Dan's audio cuts out every time he starts up Halo, because Halo Master Chief Collection is a broken pile of poop. It is a poop sandwich.
Hello.
Hey! What's up, man?
Oh, you know. Sick again.
You're sick again? What are you doing, going to the store and sticking your hands in your mouth all the time? You're sick way too often. That's not good. Are you there?
Did it cut out again?
Yeah, it cut out again. I thought it would have already happened, but I guess it just happened now. Oh, I'm glad you made it. I didn't want to have to do this mission by myself. With no trial runs or anything, it's going to take me forever. This mission blows. Sometimes.
Alright,
so... Oh, okay, it's no big deal. I'm just glad you showed up. I already started doing it by myself. I set it on normal, and the game already killed me. My grenade didn't kill anything, and they ran around and killed me. It cheated, in other words, because you know how games do. I even took a video of it and saved it. No, I'm just kidding. I mean, I did die, but... Anywho. Hey, do you know the glitch where you pop up on the wall and you can get a whole bunch of enemies to despawn and you can skip a bunch of stuff?
What part is that at?
Pretty much in the beginning, you hide behind a door that a hunter comes through, and then he knocks open the door and it pops you up onto the wall. And if you make a couple of jumps, you get a checkpoint, and then everything kind of despawns. I was trying to do it before the stream started, and I cannot get it to work. I was wondering if you've ever done it.
No, I've never done that. Honestly, I was never big on the glitches, so...
Me either. I just used to do them just to see if what they were like, and just to have some fun after I beat the game, but I never did this one, and I couldn't get it to trigger, but no big deal. We don't need to glitch anyway. I mean, I wouldn't want to. I do remember where the skull is and where the terminal is on this. Absolutely. For sure. So hopefully my memory is actually right this time.
Okay, because I remember where the skull is.
The skull is over by where Foehammer
lies
the dust. And the terminal is Master Chief's cryo chamber computer. Where Kelly's thing was.
Yep.
Earlier. I remember there being something in that room... Otherwise, but maybe it's just the skull from the first mission, which we never ended up actually doing on stream. I think might just be what it is.
There was a skull in the very first room we started in.
Right, behind some barrels, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh well. We didn't show them that one, but they can probably find it on their own. This mission is a great example of how crappy the old graphics are compared to the new ones. You just switch it back, it's like there's no textures or anything. It's like we're playing Destiny. Speaking of Destiny, are you going to do the new update thing that they have coming out?
I really don't want to.
I'm not going to. I was going to do anything. I would have been back when the Icebreaker came out, and I never bothered to do that, so screw it.
Yeah, I remember we talked about that briefly, but I've never been tempted to turn it back on.
Well, especially now that they announced that I cannot kill this little bastard. They announced that we're not going to be able to bring anything over but our looks. Well, that's lame, even though they added, like, all kinds of new armor stuff, which is cool. That's kind of lame. Okay, so this is the part. Let me show you. Let me blow up these poppers. And then this is the door right here. So if you come over here and crouch, he'll pop you up on the wall. And then you can do some jumps and skip a whole lot of stuff. But I can never get it to work. So let's... Nope, I fell down again. Oh well. Play Injustice 2? Nah. What I might play... I was thinking about getting Andromeda once it comes out, but then I looked it up and apparently there's like a whole bunch of graphical issues and animation issues and... Like, how do they have that kind of stuff? Where'd that grenade come from? Anyway, I don't know. I was going to get the game, and then first thing I looked up was a reason to not get the game. Not that graphics are the most important thing, but... I don't know. It just put me off to the idea of playing through another... Oops, playing through another Mass Effect.
Yeah.
Wow.
Can't see
him. I spent like 100 hours, so, like, on every individual previous Mass Effect game. I don't really want to do that again, especially if the characters look stupid.
Have you seen some of the walks they do? Like, the way they're...
Yes! They look so stupid! These guys are really aggressive with the grenades. Shit. I need to watch part 1. You need to watch parts 1 through 9. This is part 10. You've missed 9 parts. Did you die?
It's
really easy to die here. I know, that's why there's the glitch to skip it. This part blows. I don't remember him being so happy with the grenades, though. Yeah, they walk real funny if there's stairs near them. They walk really weird. If there are characters on the screen, they walk really weird. Their faces look stupid. The main character, the female version, has, like... Her mouth is, like, twice as big as it should be.
Apparently some of the lip-syncing looks like, I don't know, goldfish or something. People were making fun of
it. Oh, yeah. No. It looks like that Pingu thing. And, like, their mouths stick out real far when they purse their lips. Instead of just pursing their lips, their mouths go out like a duck beak. It's really funny looking.
How many years have they been working on this?
It's like 10 years. That's what somebody said. I'm sure it's not, actually. Alright, we need to play more carefully, because this room is not supposed to be the hardest part of the game. I'm going to leave my shotgun behind for now. I'm going to noob shot these guys.
I got stuck.
Alright, I'm going to back out. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I really want to get into it, but I can't. I can't do it. Cool, an empty shotgun. That's what I like.
Nice, man. Those are good.
I'm glad that they took that out of later installments of Halo. No more picking up empty weapons. Because that shit's annoying. Hey, we made it. Go us.
Wow.
Oh, shit.
Whoa.
Everything blows up in this game, and it hurts a lot. Okay, so this is a glitch we do need to do, though. Once we get to this front part where there's the monitor thingy, we need to skip the cutscene. Don't worry, everybody, the cutscene's not exactly interesting anyway. But if you skip the cutscene, did you blow up again? Everything,
something
I told
blew
you,
up over
everything.
There.
Yeah, so you skip the cutscene and this glass doesn't break. And if it doesn't break, You can hide behind it when these guys start attacking you, because that's helpful. And it won't break once the cutscene's over. If you let the cutscene play out, they break it in the cutscene, and then you get shot off. Which, it's not a big deal on Heroic anyway, but it's a nice tip for Legendary. All the cutscene shows, if I remember correctly, is Cortana talking to Mr. Chief about blowing up the ship's core. A fusion reactor or something like that, and that's it. So that's what we're doing now. We're going to go to the engine room. This is on Heroic. We always play on Heroic for these because that's how you're supposed to play it. Legendary just makes it exceptionally challenging. I can never remember which doors are open and closed. Oh, that one's open. Oop.
That hurt.
I don't know what you're talking about. It's just a plasma rifle. Suck it up. Just wait until I get a rocket launcher.
I just need... You're just helping me get my health back, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely. No, the cutscene's not good, trust me. It's you guys aren't missing anything from that cutscene. I mean, normally I wouldn't do it, but I wanted to show you that little tip. And I wanted to use that tip because the Sentinels suck. Fighting the Sentinels in this mission suck. Or sucks. Watch out. Oh. He was hiding. He was hiding too. Yeah, unless you have plasma weapons, the Sentinels really blow. They will cut you in half very quickly. Hunters not so much, because you have shotguns. Oop. There's an elite in here also.
Okay.
That's not good.
Alright.
I stuck the hunter. I tried to throw it over his shoulder and it stuck onto him. Oh, man.
There you are.
Yeah, I'm back. Oh, and yes, this is the last mission. One of the best missions in all. Gosh, another freaking empty shotgun. That's not going to help this situation.
It's a room full of them here.
They're all empty. The reason they're all empty is... I don't know. I don't have a tidbit for that.
Oh.
Yeah. Milky Flava, I'm glad you like the videos. Joke's on you. Not you, this guy. Nope, joke's on me. That empty shotgun's really killing me.
I'm stuck.
What the heck, man? A single shotgun shot should kill him, but I can't pick up my ammo. I bet you ended up picking it up when I died that one time. Shoot him in the butt. It's where they like it the most.
It's hard to do with this button lag.
Yeah, I was gonna say, it looks like you're having some button lag again.
I can't even turn around fully. There we go. There it is. Aren't you back?
There we go. Let me see if I can go find my gun. Is this the door? This is the door. Okay, so both hunters are dead. This elite's gonna die now, too. Take that, sucker. Where's all my guns? I'm gonna take this pistol. That's more helpful than the assault rifle is really not a useful weapon. There's my shot. Nope, that's the empty one. Damn it. Oh well. Okay, let's go. Let's push forward. That's what she said. Now I'm gonna try to. Oh, I don't have any plasma weapons. Do you have any plasma weapons? I'm gonna go get rid of my AR then. I don't need a lousy AR. Oh no. What happened? No! I need to go backwards, you stupid game. Stop turning us around.
I'm just gonna stand still until you get what you need.
There we go. I got the plasma. I got the PP. I can take these guys out with the PP. You really want to keep a plasma weapon on hand for the segments with the Sentinels. Trust me, it sucks killing them without them. Although, a well-placed sticky will take them all out if you can actually stick one. Which isn't that hard, because they're kind of big targets. They have big hitboxes. Here's a little tidbit for all you people out there. The part of the ship that blew up last time we were on this mission is not actually blown up. There's a health pack over here also. So some things that were in disarray originally are not in disarray now. And so this is the area where you get the, what's it called? Terminal. Terminal's coming up pretty soon here. If I'm in the right mind. I might be crazy. I think this is it.
No, you're right. It's upstairs.
Oh, yeah. So the cryo bay looks significantly different than it did the first time we were here. When you're in this mission, the very first mission, the skull is just behind a pile of barrels in the corner. Uh-oh. I'm all out of plasma. That didn't stick. Don't go that way! Somebody put a glowing blue thing on the floor. Alright, so the thing is right here. That's the terminal right there. Bam. Now you've gotten all the terminals. Although I don't know, did we show them the terminal on the first? Yeah, we did. We showed them the terminal. I think. Dan, do you remember if these enemies are never ending? I cannot remember. I want to say they end up stopping eventually, but
they do stop.
I'm not positive.
I'm just a lot
of rocket launcher. Hey, if you need a shotgun, there's plenty of those.
Pretty good.
I don't
there.
Think they're empty either.
That's not what I wanted to do.
I tended to keep the pistol just because I miss this pistol so much.
There's really no point for me to have one.
I'm all out of. Oh yeah.
There you
better
go.
Use the
I dropped
spray
it.
Oh no, that's okay. I decided to not use that either because it runs out of ammo way too fast on these guys. Gosh. There's a glitch where, well, I'll mention it once we get there. For now, it doesn't matter. And it's a glitch that you don't have any control over, to my knowledge. It's just one of those things that sometimes happens, and it makes your life incredibly easy. But you can't actually make it happen, to my knowledge. There's another thing I should point out. I always go the wrong way at a certain part of this map and get turned around a lot. But we're going to see if I can show you the right way. It's been quite some time. Oop, that's not the way. I mean, that's not the thing I was talking about, but that is the wrong way to go. Whoa! You just almost got shotgunned. We're going this way. Fort, turn around. It will load your buddies in front of you. You don't want to go that way, because that's going to put you in between some bad guys. You want to go this way. And this isn't what I was referencing a second ago, either. This is just another... There's a health pack right there. But you want to turn all the way around and go where that grunt is, or I'll do it. You want to go this way first. Don't go out those doors that are open yet. You want to go out here first, and you can grab some grenades and stuff. And then you can actually, well, I'm not positive, so I'm not going to do it, but I think you can blow the sentinels up from over here. But screw it. You no good. So that's why you don't go through those doors right away. The hunters are bastards, and they will just attack you right away. I'm gonna grab this health pack. Did he turn around yet? If he turns around, I'd happily... You know what? This guy needs to go.
Whoa! Wasn't even near that. Apparently I was close enough, though.
You're always close enough to explosions in this game. If there's an explosion happening, you will die from it. Oh wow, how'd I lose all my health? Oh.
Little guys jumped on you.
Oh man, I was checking the comments for a second, and then all of a sudden I'm dying. That's not fair. Don't they know? I'm trying to run a stream around here. Why won't this guy die on the first hit?
There he goes. not looking good for you.
I got the hunter. I can grab this health pack over here. I think I got the hunter. There it is. Alright, we're cooking with gas now. So you want to go to the right first and clear out the elites. Then you can worry about the fludes. You can technically skip a lot of this too, but I'd like to kill everything just to make sure they don't get me later. I'm pretty sure... Yeah, you can go this way and skip a lot because we're going to the engineering, which is that... See how it says on the floor right there, engineering? And in the new graphics, they tell you where to go. In the old graphics, you run around blind and don't know where to go. Get... These bastards just never stop. That's why I kill everything. Yeah, it's so much better with the new graphics where it actually tells you where the places are. So the armory, that was the one thing I was telling you guys about a second ago where I like always get lost on it. But that was because I was playing on the old graphics. Now that there's a... Now that there's a marker on the floor, it's going to be pretty hard to get lost. Hopefully. But yeah, we want to kill all of the fludes down here for now. Just because we may end up back here and we don't want to get attacked and lose health for no reason. Because we're going to be doing a segment on this map that, or on this mission that really sucks a lot. Lots of things attack you, they're never ending, and you're just going to have to fight a lot of dudes. We're going to go this way.
Oh, you don't want to get weapons?
We can get weapons now. I was going to do it later, but because I already have the rocket launcher. We can do it now. So yeah, this is the armory path where you go and get ammo and stuff, but you need to be aware. I'm not sure if they're in here now. It might just be later once you trigger the next segment. There's this cloaked bad guys in here. I think it might just be once you trigger the engineering room. Or is that once you come in here? Maybe, yeah, I'm thinking it's once we start the next segment. So you can come in here first. Oh, no, they are in here. Cool. And they're dead. At least that one is. There they go. Alright. They're actually pretty easy to see with the new graphics. Cool. It's so much better with the floor markings now. I never even played this. I mean, I guess I must have. Maybe I didn't play on... I might have played on the old graphics. Well, anyway, you get lots of rockets and shotguns and shit, and you really need them. But you want to save your rockets not for the bad guys, because they're going to make the next segment a lot easier than trying to chuck grenades. Yeah, so let's go back now. So now you can just go the opposite way. And you can do the stuff. Do the engineering stuff. The good thing is you can always come back and get more ammo, so that's nice. I usually go and do what I can with what I have and then get the ammo, but... We did it the smart way this time, which is smart. So this area blows a lot because you're constantly getting bombarded by bad guys and you have to do some shit. They have weapons. And not only are you fighting the fludes, but you're also fighting the sentinels. There's a lot of health packs though. You can see these health packs on the wall. There's tons of them.
I need them.
Yeah, we're probably going to need them. Especially on Legendary, this really sucks. I don't know how they figured the part time is 15, unless you're playing on easy. So, one little tidbit... Not tidbit, a little tip is you can get on these platforms. And it's a lot easier to make your shots and things if you are jumping on these platforms. Then you can just... Not the platforms.
You open up, I'll shoot.
Well, don't shoot right away. What I was going to show him is you can just do that and then jump down, and you can shoot right in the vent like this, and it's a lot easier that way. And then as soon as it blows up, it closes. And it's really, really easy. That's a tip you want to do. Oops, I'm getting stuck. The tip you want to do when you're playing solo. Otherwise, Dan's right, you can just have somebody... Oh, gosh, I cannot use these controls now. I'm so used to current control schemes.
Okay.
I'll take care of this.
I'll go to the other side.
Yeah, you can just split up and do it that way. On Legendary, it's a lot harder. But on Heroic, it's not so bad. Especially if you do that trick where you just keep landing on the same one that you're shooting. It makes it so much easier. And rockets make it a lot easier than even using grenades. You only have one left. It's super easy. That's definitely how you guys want to do that. That's not even like a cheaty trick. That's just a smart person trick.
Oh, you missed though.
That didn't count. It didn't count. They're shooting the shit out of me. Stop shooting the shit out of me. They're gonna kill me.
There it goes.
Oh, did you get it? Good, 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 good. Thank you. I don't know why that didn't count. I'm gonna die if I don't get in there. Ah. Ooh, I really... Hey, give me a health high five. Thank you. A love-hate relationship with this level. Yeah, this is a it's a tricky one. I hope I remember the routes for the driving, because I could do the Halo 3 one with my eyes closed, even at this point. But this one, because it was never a big deal, I've only done it like one time for achievements. So I don't know if I'm going to remember it. I'm probably going to crash a lot. I will show you guys a couple of not tricks, but Easter eggs. Nah, just one. I'm going to show you guys the Thirsty Grunt Easter egg. We're not going to do the Rex or the Meg one. Those are a lot harder to do, and I don't feel like it. There's some little trick in here about getting the grunts to not kill you. Like, if you get on the thing fast enough or something like that, the grunts won't fight you, and they'll just get stuck on the lift, and they'll stay with you and stuff, but I don't remember. I blew up almost instantly. I wonder how.
I don't know.
Zeno Mayo. I'm glad you like the DBZ videos, Broham. Ooh, here's a tip you guys need to know. When you're driving, if you're doing this co-op, don't put someone on the gun turret. You don't need a shooter anyway, but it throws off the balance of the Warthog and makes driving a lot harder and makes jumps act funny. That's a verifiable thing. So put them in the passenger seat or drive separate. You want to go separate, Dan, or do you want to hop on?
I'll just hop on.
Yeah, always, always, always in the passenger seat. That won't affect your Warthog. Wow, these Warthogs drive like bricks. I don't know how well I'm going to do this. Okay, so there are two shortcuts on this segment that make it a lot easier to do. I don't remember this route at all. All right, we're just going to go for it.
Just drive straight.
No, you can't go straight there. I remembered that much, at least. I think I remember it. We're going to see how effective I am at remembering the path. I'm going to be at least halfway right. Because I did do the speed run for this not that long ago. But let's see if it works. But yeah, there's two shortcuts that are just a matter of turning instead of going straight. So the trick to that is, the first one is going to be on your left after this first pillar thing. You'll see. Not pillar thing. Well, there's a pillar. You'll just see when I get there. Just ignore me for now. They probably won't kill you unless you're on legendary, by the way. Alright, so this is where you turn left. Second pillar. And then the trick to this is you always turn the same direction going out that you turn going in, and that way you don't go the wrong direction. So we turn left again. And that'll get you through, and it saves you a ton of time. And for this segment, I think you're supposed to go right over here. And just be careful. God, I'm sucky at driving this. Give me the Halo 3 Warthog any day. Okay, now there's another one of those tunnels toward the end, and that you turn to the right on that one, but there's an Easter egg within that tunnel, so make sure you do it, and I'll show you guys what to do. So for this one, we go down, and I'm pretty sure we turn as we pop out. I should have gone up there. That's okay. The trick to this area is to keep bouncing your ass off the walls, and it'll make you turn faster, like that. A lot easier. I had to learn all this shit when I was doing the speedruns, because this speedrun thing sucks. Also, there's an achievement for not getting ejected out of your car, so you have to learn all these little tips and things. But now you don't, because I already told them to you. Alright, so this area, you don't have to wait. There is an achievement for shooting both of the banshees that show up here. Because, yeah, that's what I'm doing. So we're going to get this skull. I wonder if I have to back up. I might have to back over to it. Let's see. Though the skull is up here.
You got it.
All right, so Foehammer is going to blow up right there, and there's two Banshees that are there. You can get an achievement, I think, for killing them, but you just get in the gun turret and kill them. So there's the skull right there. You have to jump on the Warthog. It's on that pipe. Whoa! Wasn't expecting that. I don't remember them doing that. Those bastards. They almost killed you. So now you have all the skulls, everybody. Woo! All right, time to pay attention. Here we go. Here's another piece of information on Legendary. You lose a minute. You see that countdown timer at the bottom? They take a minute off of it to make it harder for you on Legendary. For this segment, it's better to drive on the inner part at an angle than to keep bouncing off those little things, but it's not that big of a deal. There's a longer one of those coming up you want to be aware of. Let's hope I don't miss the next shortcut. I might do it. It's been a long time. There it is, right here. Okay, so it's right after the Foehammer thing, and then you turn right after this fiery wall, and there's a grunt down here that talks to you. That's an Easter egg. He'll never attack you, so you can let him talk if you want to, or you can kill him. You have plenty of time, but if you want to let him talk forever, he'll eat up all your time and then you die. That might have already been too long since we've been going really slowly. We're going to give it a shot, though. So I turned right coming into the tunnel, you turn right going out of the tunnel. And now, there's a... not much to do. So there's a little bit of a glitch, not a glitch, an Easter egg. If you jump out at the right time and go up above where those flaming barrels were, there's another Easter egg up there. It's not the easiest thing to do, and I don't want to not get my time, so I'm just going to keep going straight. And we have plenty of time, I think. We did have a spare minute since we were playing on Heroic. So a little trick here is if you put a grenade under the back end of your car, and as it flips, you shoot it with a rocket, you can get your car to flip over these barrels and keep driving, but you don't need to do that because this is the end. Just survive. This is actually somewhat challenging on Legendary, trying to survive this part right here, but it's not that bad. And that's it. Timothy Shepard, what's up? That wasn't bad. We did it in 29 minutes. And the part-time's 15 quick. And we weren't even trying. That is pretty quick. Makes me want to play the Halo 3.
And you got me the achievement for not flipping over.
Heck yeah. Alright. I guess I did remember it pretty well. I did it so many times when I was trying to get the... There's one for... I think maybe it's on Legendary. You have to do it in under 5 minutes or something. The Warthog run. I don't know what it is. There's some other thing. I spent like a whole day trying to do that. It sucked. Really good use of my time for sure.
Oh, yeah.
If you do this on Legendary, there's a bonus cutscene with Johnson and an Elite getting a little friendly. But on Heroic, we won't have that, unfortunately.
Covenant Armada obliterated and the Flood. We had no choice. Halo, it's finished.
No, I think we're just getting started.
Interesting thing, he takes his helmet off right here, so people went in and moved the camera around using some mods to see what his head looks like. They never modeled a head, so he actually just has another Master Chief helmet on his head. That's not actually just a meme, it's a real thing. Most people think they have a head model in there, but they don't. Griff Productions, yeah, we beat it. I had a pretty flawless Warthog run there. Wasn't expecting to do that. I didn't know if I would remember it, but it kind of came back to me. It's like second nature. Yeah, 28 minutes. That is not bad for not trying at all. That was pretty fast. That was one of the faster missions we've done. Oh, well. I don't know. I don't remember it being that easy to blow up the reactors either. That went pretty smoothly. Well, now you guys know how to do it quickly, if you need to. What were you going to say, Dan?
I just got a couple of achievements. Apparently I beat all the campaigns on Heroic difficulty. Didn't know I did that.
There you go. I'm going to get some once we start playing Halo 3 and 4, I think, because I never did them on this game. Mm-hmm. I did some of them, but maybe Halo 2 also. I don't know. I think I did Halo 2. All right, guys. Well, that's it. Next week, we're starting Halo 2 Anniversary, which is fantastic. It looks like it's from the future. That's how good the graphics are. They're not actually that good, but they're pretty good. They're pretty good. So, yeah, we'll be starting that next week. Halo 2 picks up right where Halo 1 left off, though you should read the books because the books fill in a ton of information, and they're fantastic. They're really, really good, so you guys should definitely check that out. So next Thursday at 7, we'll be doing Halo 2, continuing our Halo Let's Play thing. We also play Thursdays, I already said. Saturdays at 8 and Mondays at 7. Those are usually Overwatch. Actually, they're probably going to be Overwatch only because I'm not playing GTA anymore because that last mission made me angry. So that's it, guys. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time.